Here is a step-by-step guide on how to effectively provide first aid treatment for chemical burns. Start with a thorough assessment of the victim's overall condition. Determine the degree of chemical burn they have, whether it's first, second, or third degree. First-degree burns are superficial with mild redness and swelling. Second-degree burns go deeper, with blisters, severe redness, and leaking fluids. Third-degree burns are penetrating and appear blackened, dry, or leathery. It is also important to assess their overall well-being, including vital signs like heart rate, blood pressure, and respiratory rate. The next step is to flush the affected area with large amounts of lukewarm water to dilute and remove the chemical for at least 20 to 30 minutes. This process is more effective when done in an emergency wash station such as an eye wash station or safety shower. Identifying the chemical involved is critical. Information on the chemical can usually be found on a safety data sheet, which details its properties and handling measures. After rinsing, cover the burn lightly with a sterile, non-adhesive bandage or a clean cloth. Avoid using fluffy cotton or anything that might stick to the burn. It is crucial not to use any cream, ointment, fats, or other substances to the burn unless directed to do so by a medical professional. Whether it's a minor or severe chemical burn, it is essential to seek medical help. A qualified medical personnel will conduct a detailed physical examination to help determine the extent of the burn, assessing the affected surface area and depth. In severe cases, laboratory tests like blood tests and imaging studies may be needed to evaluate deeper tissue damage and potential systemic effects. Chemical burns are a serious matter, and knowing how to respond can significantly affect recovery. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more safety insights.